the things I've seen on the battlefields of the frontier, the pilot is the true dominant force. Fast and agile. Graceful, yet devastating. Perceptive, resourceful, and relentless. A pilot sees the world differently. Sheer walls become flanking routes. Pilots fight differently. Experienced in deception and maneuver, even overwhelming odds shift in their favor. But what truly separates the pilot from all the grunts and machines of the battlefield is the bond between a pilot and a Titan. To a Titan, a pilot can only be stopped by overwhelming force or an equal. The frontier has been the only home I've ever known. For years, our lands have been destroyed by the IMC, forcefully taking our resources, polluting and destroying our planets, and killing us off if we try to resist. Despite recent victories at Demeter and beyond, we have a long way to go before the IMC is defeated. Now, I serve as a rifleman in the militia, fighting to free the frontier. I'm a long way from becoming a pilot. But when that day comes, I hope I can live up to the honor.
Here we go, Rifleman Cooper. Oh, hell. Ship must have power cycled the Simpod since last time. We'll have to recalibrate it.
All right, we're good to go. Let's see how much you remember from last time. Setting the neural link. Not quite the same as a Titan link, but it's similar. To learn new skills, we need to be in the right state of mind.
That's my partner, BT. He's a Vanguard class. Homegrown militia technology. The first Titan chassis we designed ourselves. One we didn't have to steal from the IMC. Go ahead, Rifleman. Call on your first Titan. Look up at the sky. There he is. All right, Rifleman. Sounds like it's about to hit the fan. I'm pulling you out.
Powering down all non-essential systems.
Cooper! Ready up!
Easy, Cole. He just left VR. He needs a minute to decompress. He'll be ready to go. Trust me.
Yes, sir.
Heads up. They're killing us. Trying to, anyway. Good session in there. You'll get the hang of it someday. We'll make a pilot out of you yet, Rifleman. But not today. No time.
Lastimosa.
Anderson?
You son of a bitch. See you down there.
We're gonna see a new planet today. Maybe even die on it. See you down there, Rifleman. Good luck.
Get your ass out of the Simpod, Cooper. Meet at the dropship.
Ambush.
rifleman, class 3, Jack Cooper. Stabilize. 250 milligrams of sansufentanil administered. Caution. Temporary side effects. Nausea. Dizziness.
You're in bad shape. Hold on. This might knock you out, but you should be okay when you wake up.
Lastimosa, hostile titans inbound. Apex predators.
Copy that, BT. Mercenaries. Stay down, Cooper.
BT, let's go!
We have 18 hours! 18 hours until the Ark is sealed and ready for delivery. Oi, Rika! Leave the corpses alone, you sick bastard. We've got a job to do, eh? We make corpses, we don't clean them up. Let's go!
Transfer authorization to new pilot, Link, Bravo Tango, 7274. Cooper, take my Titan. Use my helmet in my jump kit. This is the real thing. Take care of him.
records. Data core reinitialized. Ocular system online. Adjusting focus. Are you all right, pilot?
I think so. Wait, did you just call me pilot?
Yes. The late Captain Lastimosa gave you the provisional rank of acting pilot. Congratulations on your promotion. You may call me BT.
BT. Got it.
My systems are rebooting, but a third battery will accelerate the process. I will remain here. Power at full capacity. Pilot, we must establish a neural link in order to proceed. Please embark when ready. Establishing neural link. Neural link established. Rifleman Jack Cooper, you are now confirmed as acting pilot of BT-7274. Protocol 2, uphold the mission. Our orders are to resume Special Operation 217. Rendezvous with Major Anderson of the SRS. I'm detecting incoming enemy forces. Protocol 3. Protect the pilot. Reinitializing critical systems. Vortex shield online. The vortex shield catches incoming rounds and missiles. Release the button to launch any captured objects back at the enemy. Acolyte pod is online. This shoulder-mounted rocket pod will lock onto multiple enemy targets. The longer you hold down the button, the more locks you will achieve. Neural link complete. Primary weapon control and motion link re-established. Pilot, enemy Titanfall detected. We will have to fight our way to safety. Get ready.
Great. Just gotta kill a few bad guys.
A positive attitude can only improve our situation.
Militia Titan spotted, chassis number BT-7274. Taking fire.
Effectiveness rating has increased. Pilot, I detect more IMC salvage teams on the way. Our only chance of survival is to uphold our mission of rendezvousing with Major Anderson. Until then, you and I are on our own. Pilot, the IMC will continue to search for us. Our only chance of survival is to rendezvous with Major Anderson 60 clicks from our current location. We will have to improvise and adapt if we wish to survive.
You were not invited to Kane's party. And that's why you're dead. Well, well. Another runaway hero. With an SRS Vanguard class Titan. Well, now we're talking. Bring it a 9-29 fight.
Let's get this party started, scrub.
Stay out of Kane's thermite resonator. It causes heavy damage.
Go ahead, Kane can kick a few hits. I can keep going.
you. You gotta sleep sometime.
Still intact. We should retrieve it.
A Vanguard Titan and his pilot are breaking through the facility. Over. Kane, we need reinforcements in the tunnel. Kane, how copy? Over.
Decrypt enemy communications has a strong history in warfare. This will work to our advantage. In order to survive, we must keep moving. Major Anderson went this way. It could be a shortcut to the rendezvous point. I recommend we proceed.
Playground. I'm not paying you to be clever. You scuttle that place if you have to, eh? Let's go. Ash, tell me you killed that pilot.
I am dealing with him.
Stop getting caught up in your games.
Am I not allowed to enjoy myself while I work?
Not when your work suffers.
Point taken. Ash out.
Don't worry. For the price I'm putting on his head, you can buy all the toys you want.
Sector 4 charting. Detonate charges 21 through 29.
To all IMC personnel, this is Ash. I am sorry to report due to your inability to contain a security breach. I have been forced to scuttle the entire complex. Some of you may consider this overkill. It is. I suggest you evacuate.
Pilot, I do not know what you did, but a series of explosions just weakened the manipulator arm. I have broken free.
Lisk has put a high price on your head, pilot. Dead or alive, that makes you worth something to me. Let us begin.
Salvo coordinates.
Your mistake will be your undoing.
Get captured again, BT.
I will avoid all shortcuts.
Overseer requests all teams working on the ARC analysis report to the lecture hall for General Marder's presentation. Thank you. You're forgetting he's got hands.
What just happened?
There are distortions throughout this facility, and they appear to be causing a rift in time. I advise caution until we have further information.
A rift in time? How does that happen?
Unknown. Militia SRS has documented several cases on other planets. A common feature of such rifts is a massive energy surge. Be careful, pilot.
Decisively neutralizing the militia forces, we will in fact...
Yes, pilot, may I help you?
But lest we lose sight of the bigger picture, remember those losses are ultimately replaceable by the inexorable march of human reproduction. By decisively neutralizing the militia forces, we will in fact save the...
Yes, pilot, may I help you?
Reminder, identification credentials must be displayed at all times.
What is this place?
The IMC has multiple scientific research facilities throughout the frontier. However, this particular one is unlike any known to the militia.
How so?
The large rings within the main campus are not an IMC technology. Its design is foreign, and its function is unknown. Strange. I'm picking up traces of my own data signature within this area. The distortions must be affecting my scans. None of these remains match the genetic profile of Major Anderson. He may still be alive. I recommend you check the main lobby of reception. I would accompany you, but unfortunately, my chassis will not fit through the door.
I'm doing my keep.
On the contrary, you are proving yourself to be much more than a Class 3 rifleman. I suspect Major Anderson will be impressed.
Thank you.
BT, I found Anderson. He's, in the ceiling.
Objective complete. We have rendezvoused with Major Anderson.
That's cold, BT.
Correct. Anderson's current temperature is 17 degrees Celsius, below the threshold of human survival. Pilot, if you hand me Anderson's helmet, I will analyze it. With the death of Anderson, command of Special Operation 217 now transfers to you. Congratulations on your field promotion, Pilot Cooper. The following is Anderson's mission briefing from Commander Sarah Briggs of the Militia SRS.
Major Anderson, 2 weeks ago we intercepted IMC comms. They found something on Titan. A massive blast of energy was discharged at this location, creating time distortions. I want SRS on the ground to infiltrate the facility.
Roger that. I'll get some answers.
This wrist-mounted device we recovered during Operation Grizzly should protect you. We know the IMC have contracted Kuban Blisk and his mercenaries to protect something critical there, so watch your back. And Anderson, you know how much I love writing death reports, so don't go it alone. The SRS is a team.
Pilot, the data Major Anderson collected appears to be incomplete. We are duty-bound to uphold and fulfill Special Operation 217. Recommend we locate Anderson's wrist-mounted device before proceeding.
I didn't see any device on Anderson.
It must be on the other half of his corpse. I detect a breach in the security services building. I will provide access. I will remain here and scan the ring structure while you investigate the facility for intel and the missing device.
Nice. Maybe next time you can throw me.
Noted.
Let's box him in.
Copy that, Control! On our way, Control!
Activating log playback.
Anderson log 341. The IMC found something, all right. It can fold space and time. They sure as hell didn't build it, but they're restoring it. Whatever they're planning, it's potentially catastrophic. Anderson out. Anderson's log 342. The fold weapon's power source is called the Ark. Doesn't look like they've perfected the casing. This one's empty. The Ark must be somewhere else. Anderson out.
Ark prepped for delivery and en route to the test chamber.
Marder's log 21B, human specimen 3.4. The experiments on the IMS Odyssey's colonists are underway. Soon we will discover the long-lasting effects the Ark has on organic matter and brain function.
They were targeting this planet's moon as a test. This damn thing was just a test. One of our own planets is next. They're going to hit Harmony, and they moved up the timeline. I have to get this intel to Sarah.
Hold it right there, Pilot. I'm located.
That was Major Anderson's final recording. Cooper, based on your recon of this facility, I may have a plan. Meet me outside.
I would like to spend time today to talk about the value of human life. There is no value to human life. Now that I have your attention, to be more precise, human life to a certain limit is expendable. We are self-perpetuating yet self-destructive. Adaptable yet flawed, and always, always resource-intensive. We are endless consumers of resources. But most relevant to our research here is one undeniable fact, that human life is abundant. Overpopulation of any colonized world is a given. Through the lens of cold objectivity, it is irresponsible to say that all individuals on such worlds are actually indispensable. Millions of humans die across the colonized worlds every day by any number of causes. Human life is expendable. Now our problem is twofold. On the one hand, we are faced with a hostile frontier populace opposed to our commercial pursuits for the greater good. And on the other hand, there is a never-ending cry for natural resources, demanded of us by the greater populations of the core systems. We must have order on the frontier if we are to achieve true progress, but the militia, in its provincial myopic lack of vision, refuses to accept this. Thus, we are at war. Now the bitter truth. Reinforcements from the core systems will not arrive for several more years. The militia gain strength day by day, taking back one planet after another. Our choices are limited. Drastic action must be taken. Again, I remind you all of one simple truth, that human life is abundant. And, as distasteful as it may sound, human life is, in truth, expendable. And so that brings us to this planet Typhon, where we have discovered a gift, a machine that will do more than change the tide. Call it fate, call it evolution, call it what you will. The truth is, we have discovered our resolution, and in it lies a weapon with a powerful ability to fold space and time. We don't know who built it,
we do know that it is quite old. And most importantly, we have learned enough to bring it to life. As we use this fold weapon, we will manipulate space-time, targeting anything we desire, sundering entire planets. Our restoration efforts in the mountains are nearly complete, but one task remains. We must complete a small-scale test here first, to tune the power source, or the arc, as our colleagues tend to call it. Once we have accomplished this, we will transfer the power source, the arc, to the full-scale site, and destroy one populated militia planet and then another, until they capitulate. We will open an Einstein-Rosen bridge, sending through thousands of concentrated gravitational waves. This will rip apart and sunder every molecule, every atom, and every living thing we target, resulting in total loss of life. But lest we lose sight of the bigger picture, remember, those losses are ultimately replaceable by the inexorable march of human reproduction. By decisively neutralizing the militia forces, we will in fact safeguard the existence of the human race, extending its reach and power towards a prosperous and bright future.
I recommend you meet me at the rings in order to scan the Ark's energy signature.
12-14, hostile pilot, everyone, back up!